Hello, this is Mark from TradeInform.com and welcome to this video on how to backtest a stock market trading strategy using Excel. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can use Excel to develop, refine and optimize your own trading strategies. First, I would like just to remind you that if you like this video, please hit the like button. And if you want more videos like this on Excel and testing trading strategies, please hit the subscribe button. So on the screen at the moment, I have two stock market indices. I have the NASDAQ 100 Tech Index and I have the S&P 500, largest 500 cap US stocks. Now I'm showing a particular section of recent history here since 2000, and the reason I've chosen this particular time period is because we've got some ups and downs in the stock market. Historically, this is what we can tend to expect. The markets have always tended to rise, and these have been spaced in with some significant declines. So the declines that we've had in recent years have been the dot-com crash in 2001-2002, and the financial crisis of 2008 and 2009. Now, overall, these markets have tended to rise, but one of the things that many of us use trading strategies to do is to smooth out our returns and try to reduce our drawdowns. Even on the plan that we've got on the screen, we can see that the NASDAQ 100 fell by something like 80% in just a couple of years. And even the S&P 500 fell by over 50% during the financial crisis. So the trading strategy that I'm going to demonstrate today tries to use both of these stock indices. Now, it's a common thought that you can find out there on the internet that stocks are generally doing well when the NASDAQ is outperforming the S&P. And conversely, if the S&P is outperforming the NASDAQ, then we can expect stocks are not doing so well. But how can we turn this bit of received wisdom into a trading strategy? Well, one way that we can do this is we can use Excel to test our theory. Now, I've got here a trade-informed backtest model. And you can use these backtest models to test all sorts of trading strategy. You can change the data, you can change the time frame, you can test a multitude of different technical indicators and price action, entries and exits. And you combine that with long and short entries and different ways, stop losses and profit targets. All of these are programmed in Excel and use normal Excel formulas. If you would like more information about these spreadsheets, there is a link on the screen at the moment and below this article. So please click on that if you want the more information. Now I'm going to demonstrate how easy it is to use these spreadsheets and how we can test our theories. So I've already got the NASDAQ information in here. So the next thing we need is the S&P 500. So all I need to do is get my data. I'm just going to simply copy and paste this directly in, just making sure that the dates match up. And there we can see we've got the open high, low close and volume data from the S&P 500 as well. Now I want to compare these two markets, and there are many ways that this can be done, but today I'm just going to look at using an exponential moving average. And we can calculate this very easily in Excel. So first of all, we just use the equals average formula. Now this gives us a simple moving average, and we need one of those before we can start the calculations for the EMA. Now the calculation we use, put in a couple of brackets to the start, we take the most recent close data and we subtract from that the most recent average, previous period's average, and then we multiply that by our EMA factor. Press F4 to make that an absolute reference cell, and then add to that previous period's average. Make sure our brackets average out. So there we have the first of our EMA averages. If I just double click that, it copies it down to all the cells below nice and quickly. Now I said we're going to use a ratio of these two, and to get a ratio, all we're going to do is divide the NASDAQ by the S&P. Click enter, click double click, and then we have all our formulas, all our calculations in there. Now the thing I've got next to this is just a simple measure of the ratio. Now we don't need this because you could just take it straight from the ratio, but one of the beauties about using Excel for all sorts of analysis is it's very visual, and there's often times where we want to check and look at the data, and we can easily see it here because we've used a color to indicate when the ratio is rising, indicating that the NASDAQ is stronger, and when it's falling, indicating that the S&P is stronger. Now all we need to do is come up with some entry criteria, and the simplest one of all is going to be when we have a changeover, when the ratio turns from pointing downwards to pointing upwards. So I'm going to say when this is equal to 1 and the previous period is equal to minus 1. Double click again, and there we have the strategy programmed into it. Now I've already put in a close, you can see that here, and the positions close when the ratio changes in the opposite direction. Okay, so we can see the results in the screen, on the screen at the moment. We can see this is the underlying market here is the NASDAQ, because we're using that to open and close our trades. And we can see we've got this huge decline here. Another still fairly significant decline here before the recent run-up over the past, 8 to 9 years. And we can see how this is by comparison in this trading strategy graph. We can see that we have a general rise-up, although we shouldn't forget that there is some periods when we have fall, but mostly we're heading in the right direction. In particular, we're looking at the maximum drawdown. So we've got a maximum drawdown of 16.3, which is quite low. Over this period of time, it's quite a nice little drawdown, which is suggesting that our theories, there might well be some validity to them. Now we've got, once we've got it loaded into our spreadsheet, we can do all sorts of things. We can check the EMA, we can check different values of the EMA, we can try a longer, put it up to 100, and we can see that we have fewer changeovers and we have a relatively smoother rise up. We might want to use a profit target, or we might want to get rid of it, set it to a very high level. And we see again, this changes how the strategy operates. We might feel more comfortable with a stop loss, and we can see how different values of stop loss affect the strategy. It's easy to do this. We can do this with a click of the button. So if I set this back here, we might want to show what difference it is, what difference leverage would make. At the moment, we're using a 1-to-1 leverage. What about if we want to double that? We can see that our net profit increases by more than double that amount, but we're also seeing a rise in the max drawdown. If I was to increase it to 4 times, then we have quite a considerable net profit, but again, at the risk of our drawdown increasing. Now we might want to go back to our strategy and see, well, what would happen if we used a simple moving average as a filter? Well, we can, I've got a 20 period SMA already programmed in here. So we could say, take the close, and we always want the close to be greater than that SMA before a trade is opened. And I just press enter, double click, and we can have a look how the strategy looks now. So you can see here that with some relatively simple tools, we can come up with quite a sophisticated model that can look at various different situations and see what has performed best over the historical period. So I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope you found it useful. And if you would like more information about the trading, the financial markets, about in particular using Excel to backtest trading strategies, please visit tradeinform.com. There is a link on the screen. And if you want more videos like this, please check the next video in this sequence, how to backtest a trading strategy in Excel.